Welcome to all our viewers. I'm Ananya Singh from the Children's Post, and today we are extremely fortunate to have with us Ma'am Shilpi Shankar, currently in Abu Dhabi. With a wide range of experience, she's a chartered accountant, has worked in HCL Technologies, been a consultant in SAP, worked in ADNOC, and moved on to become a housewife, and is currently a Vedic maths teacher. Welcome, ma'am. It is an honor to have you here with us today.
Well, it's the pleasure is mine. It's definitely a wonderful experience to have an interview with you.
So, ma'am, getting straight to the point, can we please start by you briefly describing your professional journey till today?
Yes, definitely. Well, I was an average student, but from my childhood, I was very fond of becoming a CA because I had seen my uncle doing it. And fortunately, I cleared it, and I really was fortunate enough to get a placement in HCL Technologies. I had very good experience there. Apart from that, before coming into HCL Technologies, I had the privilege of working with some of the famous chartered accountants in Delhi. Then came HCL Technologies. From there, I shifted to SAP Financial Consulting. I worked with SAP Global Deliveries. After that, I moved on after getting married and coming to Abu Dhabi. Here I had the privilege of working with Abu Dhabi National Oil Company, ADNOC. Once it was my first baby was expected, that time I quit the job and became a full-time mom and a homemaker. Now that I've got two girls and they're quite grown-ups now, then I thought of going back and doing something, and I learned in that period Vedic mathematics, and I was just bowled over it. So since then, I took this as a, I became very passionate about it, and since then, I'm just a Vedic maths teacher as of now.
Why Vedic maths? Being a chartered accountant, which is a difficult task to accomplish in itself, ma'am, why did you not start coaching people into becoming a CA? What is it in Vedic maths that piqued your interest?
Well, that's a very interesting question. We already have a lot of chartered accountants. It's a very well-known field. Everybody knows about it. And we have so many chartered accountancy teachers and institutes which are providing specialized knowledge of each and every subject there. And it's very famous. But Vedic mathematics is not at all famous. Or even if people know, they are hesitant to go ahead. That means, what is it? It is a big question mark for everyone, and nobody wants to explore it. So the main purpose after learning Vedic mathematics, I found that, okay, CA tuitions, definitely it's always there, but you have so many in abundance that I'll be just one in a big pond, one fish in a big pond. But after coming into Vedic mathematics, when I got acquainted with this, and I realized that we have so much hidden potential in our, you know, ancient scriptures, our Vedas, our Upanishads, and I was like simply amazed that big calculations made so easy. And I was like wondering, why were we not taught that in school that time? What was that? Why we left our ways of teaching and methodology of teaching and shifted on to, well, that's something now we cannot do. Why? So we have to, you know, take corrective steps. So that's what my main aim now is, become like, okay, if I can spread Vedic mathematics in any manner, I think that's the best. That's the best return I could give to my country.
That is an extremely important feeling, which I think all of us should feel for our own country. But a general opinion that I have noticed when Vedic maths is mentioned is that it is much more difficult and complicated than the Western counterpart, which is currently taught in schools. How do the current methods taught in schools compare to the lesser known methods of Vedic maths?
Well, what your general perception is, my perception is totally different. This is one of the easiest ways and a very coherent style of teaching. Okay, if you know the basic sutras, there are 16 sutras, And if you are aware of it, we've just touched the tip of the iceberg. We're saying we are not all into it. We do not know the details of these sutras. But whatever knowledge we have as of now is mind-blowing. It is as simple as, you know, if once you start knowing Vedic mathematics, you start loving the subject. In fact, the students who whom I have taught, their reviews, there are two girls who did not like mathematics and their mom just said that, okay, we'll put them in Vedic maths. After a couple of, means after almost 15 classes, I asked them, so how is it? Have you, I hope mathematics is okay for you. So the girl says, ma'am, I don't like maths now, but I love it. It's simply that I'm playing with the numbers, the same number, which I was so afraid of or scared of. The moment maths used to come, oh my God, it's a big thing. But now here, when you are just playing with the numbers, just think about any number. And there is so much research on each and every number that you can, you means trust me, it is simply amazing. And as far as why it is considered or such a thing has been spread about it, that it is difficult to understand, it's not at all. It's because the people who want to promote whatever they want to, for the other things, they will definitely say that it is very difficult. Don't go for it. Go for this something which is very easy. And so basically what I would like to mention here is that Vedic mathematics is more scientific and based on observation. You look at the numbers and you can come to the answers. The moment you look at the question and the answer is in your mind, because it is very scientific. It is based on, you know, a very coherent sutras which are there. You know a couple of them and you're able to play around with the numbers, juggle around with the numbers, and you can get come to the answer. And it is accurate. And the speed is amazing. I'll just show you a couple of examples how it happens. Suppose I say that you figure out the square of 999 or 4 times 9. Okay. How much time do you think it will take for you?
At least a couple of minutes.
Yeah. And here, following the formula n minus 1 and n minus t, and here you have t square. Is it visible? So it
yes.
is 9999 minus 1 and minus 0001 square. And here my answer is 9998001. This is my answer. Okay. You just look at the number and you can get the answer. I have shown you the steps so that you know that it's not just out of the blues. There is a certain pattern, a certain set of formulas that we use, and then we get to the answer. Similarly, if a number as big as 1020 multiplied by 1018. How much time? Leave aside the calculator. I'm saying it's plus 2020 plus 018, and my answer is here 1038360. This is my answer.
That was amazingly fast.
Okay. Another one. If I simply give you 65 square, how do you get it? You just do 6 times 7 and you get it to 5 times 5. 4225 is the answer. Okay. There are big numbers which the calculator is not that precise and you can get it. Like the one I showed. Like suppose it is 9999, as many times you take the 9 and square. If you try to do this on the calculator, after certain digits, it comes like 1E or something of the sort. But here you can precisely say that 6, 7, 8, 3, 6, 7 nines, right? So my answer will be One, two, three, four, five, six, and the seventh will become eight, and again 0 0 0 0 0 1. Right? So it becomes that easy. That's why it is said, I just have to be very particular about the number of zeros because it's like 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. But the more you practice, the more easily it comes. Last one, if I ask you, and it's all about 44 into 46. Okay, what is the answer? Simple, 4 times 5 and 4 times 6. So answer is 2024. As you go, these are the simple methods of calculations and multiplication, squares. The best part is square root. You look at the digits and you don't have to pick up the pen. You can just tell the answer of perfect squares looking at the numbers. So it is magical. And after learning it, I realized that why don't I spread this knowledge to children who have maths phobia? It removes such that it removes all your anxiety, all the fear that you have. And it's not only that, it's me who's saying, all the IIT graduates, I was just reading a report, these IIT guys, they're working and using these sutras to implement many new technologies and other things. They are going back to the roots. They are learning the same things. So why not I start teaching people something which is of tremendous importance and which is currently not being taught in school. I hope they take cognizance of this and they start teaching this from childhood. But this is amazing. For me, it was amazing, and I really enjoy learning also as well as teaching. And I'm still in the process of learning, you know. I told you, we've just touched the tip of the iceberg.
Was amazing. I think the next person to join your class is going to be me.
Most welcome anytime.
And I'm sure this is going to help in the future as well a lot because such fast calculations are like time saving.
The time saving, and then it is that you get more time to concentrate on the bigger problems rather than all these small things. And the best part, it's accurate. Your speed is there. That these are the two main things. You have a very clear mind that okay, this is done. I am relaxed from this part. I have to focus on the bigger issues of the problem given in the exam.
In the 21st century, money occupies a major role in our lives. How, in your opinion, is this affecting the present and future of students and Vedic maths in general? Because you mentioned that Vedic maths itself is right now not extremely popular. So how is it actually ending up affecting Vedic maths?
See, nowadays money being the main thing, people are in a competition of getting more and more certificates. Get me a certificate so that I can put it in my CV, which gives more weightage to my CV, and I end up getting a highly paid job. So the right now main focus is on collection of certificate rather than gaining knowledge. Okay, that is as per me. What I am seeing generally, okay. I don't want to complete the full course. Can you give me the certificate? Just give me the certificate. That is what I want. So when you are not focused on knowledge, for you, the quantity matters rather than the quality. So similarly, we can see what sort of especially in our generation, I can say that it's a personal opinion, it's not for others, but yes, so what I feel is since people are spending money to earn more and more knowledge, in the sense that you're paying so much donation. So people, when they come out from any particular university or after doing anything, they are in the mode of recovering the cost of their education. So everything is centralized around money only. I'm not saying money is not important. Money is equally important. But knowledge and money, if you weigh them, knowledge should be under, you know, it must be weighing more as compared to money. So at any given point of time. So my only request is that please do not go in for any education just for the sake of collection of certificate. Whatever you want to do, whichever subject, I'm not focusing only on Vedic math, I'm just saying whatever you do, do it with full passion and learn it enthusiastically, because all, each and every knowledge that you get at this point at your age or amongst teenage, you know, in the later years, that is, maybe you find it very insignificant as of now. But as you grow, you will see nothing is insignificant. So if you do anything passionately right now, entire life, you will be thankful that, okay, that time I paid attention to it, I concentrated, and see, today it is helping me. Whether it is music, whether it is art, whatever you're doing, just do it passionately, learn it with the correct attitude and approach. That is the only thing. And as far as how is money affecting Vedic maths, obviously teachers are not paid highly in our country. They are the ones who are molding the students or the next generation. And if they are not paid well, you can understand the quality and how it all affects them, right? So teachers, especially in a country like India, where, you know, we revere teachers like Guru Govindo khade kaake lage pao balihari guru apne govind diyo bataye. So if God and the teacher is in front of me, whom should I revere first? So I will worship the teacher first, because he is the one who has connected me to the God. So in our country, teachers are on high pedestal, should be on high pedestal, but that is not the case as of now. So since teaching as a profession is not lucrative, people are not going ahead towards that. So, okay, if you have nothing to do, I'm not saying they're all, but yes, we have very good teachers in our country, no doubt about it. They're really, I respect all of them. But yes, given an option, nobody generally prefers to go and become a teacher. Means that's not in the first three things. You know, from a childhood, a person might dream to become a doctor, an engineer, or anybody. But okay, teacher, okay, we'll think of it. How much is the salary? It won't be up to the mark. They are, you know, made to work and slog. They're not paid. That's a general approach that everybody has for the teachers. And the same thing sinks in for us also. So going by that, since money is equally important, I'm just saying that money and Vedic maths, when you say money is not there, either education is there, and another thing, Lakshmi and Saraswati never go together, right? So that is also there for us. That's, I hope I've answered your question.
Absolutely, ma'am, and given some amazing life advice as well. I also noticed when talking to my peers that different kind of perceptions have come up regarding Vedic maths. One of the most common that I heard was that we have to learn such a lot of sutras. They are so difficult. Sutras are the most difficult thing on the planet. Is this true? And how is this perception affecting students in learning Vedic maths?
Again, I would like to say that no, I do not agree with that. Sutras are there, but it depends on the teacher, how you're being taught. If you just put it on all in one platter, definitely it's very heavy. Like I have this book of Vedic Mathematics, that is the original book of Swami Krishna Tirthaji Maharaj. And it's very heavy. If you read this book, you won't understand anything. But the way you have been taught a step by step by your teacher, like I was blessed to have a good teacher who taught me like with baby steps. And it made my life so easy that it sunk in me also. And now that when I am teaching to other children and other ladies rather, they're saying that it's amazing. It's so easy. We were not aware that these sutras are so easy. The applicability of Vedic maths is so easy. So going by that, and it's not that what I am saying, it's all there, also recorded in all the feedback forms that I get. No child has, after learning Vedic maths, none of the child has said that it's very difficult. Everybody's written, it is so much fun, it is so much interesting, it is so easy, life's become easy. And children who are of this grade 7, 8, 9, they've started applying that in their classes. They say, "Ma'am, I've started using these sutras in my classes." And you know, the assessment, which was for 40 minutes, which people were saying is very lengthy, I was able to finish in 25 minutes, ma'am, because I applied all these sutras. I said, "Wow, that's a very good compliment for me." So it makes a lot of difference. It's about the applicability. And especially when the children are learning, they have a different approach. They are getting the sums and they can understand that, okay, how they can apply it in their school. But for ladies who are learning, they do not have that benefit of getting mathematics sums and relating it. So they have to learn by themselves. So children are really picking up very fast, and none of them have till now said that anything is difficult. Yeah, it takes a bit of time to understand, but at least in my basic course, all the children, whosoever are there, one of my friends, she recently mentioned that my cousin's daughter was doing the course under me only. She is saying that she did not like Vedic mathematics. I mean, she does not like mathematics as a subject. She was very scared, mathsphobic. But after attending almost 10 to 12 classes, she said, "I'm really enjoying mathematics." So I said, she was telling me that, wow, that's an amazing feedback to hear something good about mathematics from her mouth. That was a big achievement, I feel. So, hey, that is definitely a myth that it is very difficult. Yes, if you just take the book and try to read the sutras, it's hell lot difficult. I cannot understand this book. But if you go step by step with the proper guidance, you can definitely understand it.
You have mentioned a lot of benefits of Vedic maths over time. The fact that it's speedy, does not take a lot of time, and easy to understand. How can it be beneficial as a career? Can it be a sustainable career option for the upcoming generation?
Well, that is something which I told you, Lakshmi and Saraswati do not go together, right? So sustainable career option, as of now, I will be very happy that people go ahead, make it as a career, and try to move ahead. That if we can have this in our schools, then definitely it is possible that we can have a sustainable career option for Vedic mathematics. But right now, the main purpose, what I feel is my purpose of teaching, I cannot say about a sustainable career option, is something which is a bit not clear as of now to me. But yes, as of now, all those people who are learning, if they take that, okay, I can spread this, I can use this knowledge in each and every aspect of my life, it makes a lot of difference. You know, as you all, as the students, all the children, when they find that, like, one of the main things of Vedic mathematics is that it helps the development of brain. You know, like you do Sudoku, you know, you do other puzzles. Why? To engage your brain. It's an exercise of your brain. Similarly, Vedic mathematics in itself is a wonderful exercise of brain, whether it's addition, multiplication, or your subtraction. Everything is left to right. Can you think, in our traditional mathematics, we do everything right to left. Here it is all left to right. Just like some people are ambidextrous, they are said, means they can write with right and left both hands. So their brain development is much, much more as compared to ours, who are just either left or right. Right. So similarly, this helps our brain development to be amazing. That is my personal view about Vedic mathematics. And once this is there, so it can be, you know, it helps you in every aspect of life. So as of now, to come to your question, that whether it's having a future ahead or not, I think it's very much an in thing right now, because talking to one of the principals in Qatar, She was saying that, wow, Vedic mathematics, that is something really everybody is quite interested to know. Nowadays, everything is picking back. You know, all our ancient texts are being revised and people are going back to the roots. So based on that, I think that definitely the future is Vedic mathematics, and it should be. I'm not taking any guarantee, but yes, it should be the end thing for another 10 to 15 years. And I think most of the people will be aware of what it is by that time.
Like it said, never lose sight of your roots.
Yeah.
Now, any last message you wish to give all our viewers?
A last message, I would just say that please remain connected to your roots. We have an amazing history, amazing past, amazing culture, amazing history, and amazing educational stuff and amazing knowledge hidden in our books. So please try to just get into it, go back to our roots, and get the glory of India back. That's the only wish I have. So that is one of the prime reasons also, that if I can impart even a 0.01% of that knowledge to people, that's a big achievement for me.
We will certainly make your wish come true. Thank you very much for taking out time from your busy schedule to give this interview. It was a privilege to have you here, and I hope that you have an amazing day ahead and an amazing career in spreading all of this important information.
Okay, thanks. It was a pleasure for me too. Thanks. Thank you.